is Kara Spinney, and today I will be presenting my audio visualization project entitled Colorful Changing Chords. I wanted to showcase my musicianship in this project, so if we scroll down here and we press anywhere on the canvas as I coded it to be able to do that, let's see what happens. You'll notice that there's four distinct notes being played every time you click on the canvas. This is because I coded an array that is a D major 7 chord. I also coded a specific color scheme for these to show the warmness of this chord. You'll notice that in every time the scale goes up, the color gets a little bit more bright. Now, if we refresh the page and we press P on our keyboard, as I also coded for this to happen, we will notice that there is another chord being played. You'll also notice that the circles, which are my D major 7 chord, are now turned into squares, and they are playing an E major 7 chord. These squares are a little bit bigger, and also, obviously, different colors. I wanted to showcase that an E major 7 chord, to me, in my opinion, is a little bit brighter than a D major chord. So I decided to use these bright yellows and greens to contrast the warm purple colors. You'll notice in my code here, I also included a squares color array to contrast what I already coded for my circles color array. This is used later in my code where my squares are being drawn here and my circles are being drawn here. I also included if statements to show that, or to allow the different states to be made. So if the mouse is pressed without pressing P, it'll create the circles, and if the key is pressed that makes the squares, they will make squares. You'll also notice in my code I have two different ADSRs for my two different states. As you can see here, this is my ADSR for my circle, and if we scroll down all the way here, this is my ADSR for my squares. So if we go back to our code, you will now notice a significant difference in the ADSR for both of my states. I wanted to show that the circles are mellow and they're very short, while as the squares that are playing an E major 7 chord are brighter, so they are a little bit more sustained. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope you enjoyed this presentation, and thank you so much.